Welcome to Zeta Turnpike Training. This video will go over the online mapping functionality on the Zeta Turnpike website. To access the online mapping, click on Online Mapping, and then select Online Mapping again from the dropdown. The first step is to select the group that you would like to view on the map. We will select All, and then click on Load. First, regarding navigation on the map, you can click and drag to move the map around and use your rollerball on your mouse to zoom in and zoom out. You can also use the pan feature to move around the map and the zoom in and zoom out feature as well. The default view of the mapping is automatic, as we can see at the top of the page. This means that as you zoom in and zoom out, the view of the map will change to the best map style. You can change this to another option by clicking on your desired choice. You can also set up a location on the map that will be called your zoom location to take you to that place on the map when you log in. If you click on Show Zoom at the top of the screen, that will display a toolbar on the bottom of the screen. You are able to zoom in and zoom out using this toolbar, as well as set up your zoom location. To set your zoom location, click on Set Zoom Location. You will be prompted to click on the map where you would like to set your zoom location. Once you've done that, subsequent logins will take you to that place on the map. At any point, if you're viewing another area of the map and you would like to go to your zoom location, click on the Go to Zoom Location button, and that will take you to the zoom location that you just set up. Let's talk about the colors that can be displayed for the trucks on the map. The three colors that are displayed on the map for a given truck will be green, red, and gray. Green signifies that the route tracker and the phone are communicating, and that the last time the truck reported in and the map refreshed, the truck was moving. Red signifies that the route tracker and the phone are communicating, and the last time the truck reported in and the map refreshed, the truck was stopped. A gray truck signifies that the route tracker and the phone have not communicated in at least 2 hours. This could be a result of the phone being outside of Bluetooth range of the route tracker, the phone being turned off, or the phone being out of cell coverage, to name a few. Also take note that the map refreshes every 2 minutes, which can be viewed at the top of the screen. You will also notice in this example that the vehicles are parked on what looks like a bullseye. This is referred to as a geocode. A geocode is a name that is given to a geographic location. The premise behind a geocode is you set up a boundary around a location, and if the truck parks in that boundary, the map will display the truck with the bullseye icon, and the name of the location will also be displayed on some of the reports in Zeta Turnpike. If you choose not to geocode locations, your reports will show a proximity and city and state instead of the name of the location that your truck stopped at. Geocodes can be set up for all locations your vehicles may stop at, ranging from domiciles to customer delivery locations to fuel stops, for example. There are two types of geocodes that can be created. One is a circular-shaped geocode, the other is a polygon. We will go through creating one of each in a few minutes. if you're creating less than 20 geocodes, they can be added one by one on the map. If you would like to create a geocode for all your locations and you have more than 20, you can fill out one of the geocode template forms on the Zeta Turnpike website and have your geocodes imported into the website so you don't have to create them one by one. The templates are found by clicking on Support and then Templates. And there's two geocode import templates. When geocodes are imported, they can only be imported in circular form, and the circle will have a default radius of 1/2 mile. The radius can be changed, but if the radius is changed, then every one of the geocode's radius will change, not just one. The Show Labels checkbox can be checked to display the unit name for each vehicle and the driver logged in if a driver is logged into their phone in that vehicle. If a driver is not logged in, just the name of the vehicle will be displayed. And then the two examples we are viewing here, there is no driver logged in, so just the name of the vehicle is being displayed. By clicking on a vehicle on the map, you can see if a driver is logged in and the location of the vehicle in the dialog box that is displayed. You can also do a breadcrumb of where the truck has been up to 24 hours prior. Click on the drop-down next to View and select the time frame you would like to see the breadcrumb map for. Once selected, another window will display with the breadcrumb map. If a vehicle has stopped in a geocoded location, you will see the icon that looks like a bullseye signifying that. Other stops will be depicted by a stop sign. Motion points are depicted by a green arrow. In the upper left corner, there is a search button as well as a button to display or hide the points list. The points list will display every time the truck reported in for the time frame you selected. The points list can be exported to a CSV file by clicking on the Excel icon in the upper left corner of the points list. At the bottom of the screen is the toolbar that will allow for zooming in and zooming out, as well as navigating through the different points on the map. This can be automated by clicking on Start Stop, and it will start taking you through each one of the points on the map automatically. You can click Stop to stop that process. Next, we will talk about the search function on the map. When you click on Search, you can search by unit, by driver, by address. You can also search for a geocode. You can also add a geocode on this screen as well. The two types of geocodes we talked about adding are a circle and a polygon. So let's do a search for a geocode. So you type in the first three letters or however many you would like to type in to find your geocode. Then click on Go to Geocode, and that'll take you to a geocode. In this particular example, we are going to set up another geocode next to the Northern Depot that is being displayed. The geocode that we will set up will be located right here. So we're going to click on Add, and we'll set up a circle. So we have to type in the ID and the name. The Depot dropdown allows you to specify if this location is a depot location or domicile. And where this becomes relevant is when you're running some of the performance reports on the website, you'll be asked a question if you would like to include depot idling. So this is where that becomes relevant. To add the circle then, if this building right here is where we want to add the geocode, click on Add Circle, go over to the map, and you'll see a crosshair come up on the map, and you click and that will set the geocode. Now, one thing to note, you do not want to overlap geocodes. So in this example, we have a geocode this vehicle is located. Now, we've also set up a geocode at another location, but the two are overlapping. So this would be something that we didn't want to do. What would make more sense right here would be to add a geocode that is shaped as a polygon. So in this case, without saving, I would close out, click back on search, click on add, and we'll add a polygon. Once again, before I do that, I'm going to do a search for this geocode again. The Northern Depot. And once again, the geocode that we want to add is right here. So now we will add a polygon. To add the polygon, we click on add, click on polygon, type in our ID and name, then click on add point. And we will now click on the map to add a point to the map. And continue doing that until you've created a geocode around the site that you wish to create one around. So you can see we're just adding points right here. And the building that we're creating this polygon around is the site that we need to set up the geocode for. Now our other geocode is located over here to the right. They won't be overlapping right now, so now we would go ahead and save changes. And now we've just updated that information successfully, and we've added that geocode. So that is how to add both a circle and a polygon geocode. If I search for a geocode and I want to do things such as rename it or delete it, I can click on the Modify tab. And the Modify tab allows you to add points to a geocode, remove points, delete. And you always want to make sure that whatever you do in terms of modifying or adding, you need to save your changes. So don't forget to do that. So that is how to modify a geocode as well. The last thing we'll talk about is the filter feature. When you click on filter, you can select a group. And we're just going to select the all group. We'll just leave it at all. And then click on apply. Now we can also change the different filter features to vehicles that have reported in more than 24 hours. And as we scroll out, we can get a better picture of those vehicles. We can also change the filter feature to both, which will include both vehicles that have reported in under 24 hours and over 24 hours. And you can also select the checkbox that will only show vehicles with drivers logged in. Thank you for watching this Zeta training session. If you have any questions about this training, please contact Zeta Support at 1-800-736-9282 or email them at turnpike_support@zeta.com.